Hi, welcome to Church on the Go. I'm Sammy, and I'll be your host. Church on the Go is a ministry of Messiah Church, offering scripture, a message, and music all in about 30 minutes. We know that this is a busy season of life for you, but wanted to offer an opportunity for you to dive into God's Word and explore it along with us when you're on the go. This April, we're diving into a new sermon series called A New Creation. You know, the Easter season is all about celebrating the new life that Jesus makes possible. And we often think of this new life in terms that are spiritual or individual, but Jesus' resurrection means new life for all of creation, including our communities and in an environment. In a world grappling with environmental concerns, I hope you'll join us as we dive into scripture to understand how the renewed life Jesus offers shapes our own responsibility to care for our environment and all of its inhabitants. I hope you'll stay tuned after a message from Pastor Tammy for a great song from our worship team.
Thanks for that warm welcome, Sammy. Hi, podcast listener. This is Pastor Tammy, and I am so excited that you're able to join me today as we begin this new sermon series, A New Creation, on a topic that is important to all of us. I want to start my message today by sharing some excerpts from Psalm 104. This scripture passage offers us a perspective of humanity as a part of God's creation, not merely rulers over the rest of creation. Let my whole being bless the Lord. Lord, my God, how fantastic you are. You are clothed in glory and grandeur. You wear light like a robe. You open the skies like a curtain. You build your lofty house on the waters. You make the clouds your chariot, going around on the wings of the wind. You make the winds your messengers. You make fire and flame your ministers. You establish the earth on its foundations so that it will never, ever fall. You covered it with the watery deep like a piece of clothing. The waters were higher than the mountains. But at your rebuke, they ran away. They fled in fear at the sound of your thunder. They flowed over the mountains, streaming down the valleys to the place you established for them. You set a boundary that they cannot cross so that they'll never again cover the earth. Lord, you have done so many things. You made them all so wisely. The earth is full of your creations. Let my whole being bless the Lord. Praise the Lord. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. The summer before I entered the seventh grade, my family moved to a very typical middle-class suburb neighborhood of San Diego. And in the years that followed, as a military family of six, we never took fancy vacations. But what my parents did was plan vacations to places where we could come to love and appreciate all the beauty that California had to offer, as well as to develop a love and a respect for nature. One of the things we liked to do as a family was go beach camping at Carlsbad State Park. This is in North San Diego County. Our family of six would rent these pop-up campers from the military base, and my mom would, practically single-handedly, pack it full of food and other important items that we'd all need for a great week of camping. Now, this campground is pretty unique, especially if you're from Minnesota. It is located up high atop a cliff that overlooks the Pacific Ocean. It's the perfect place for taking in a gorgeous California sunset. But right after breakfast each morning, we'd pack up our bags, we'd grab our beach chairs, and we'd head down this long set of steps that took us down to the beach, where we would spend the day swimming and boogie boarding, sunning, reading, throwing the frisbee around, and taking long walks in search of the perfect sand dollar. But I think my most favorite family vacations were to Yosemite National Park. It was on these trips where I first fell in love with the California redwoods. These trees are the tallest trees in the world, standing more than 300 feet tall. That's as tall as the Statue of Liberty. And you know, they live for thousands of years. Some are as old as 5,000 years. That means they were around when Jesus walked this earth. These are special trees. It's because of these trips to Yosemite as a teenager that I came to appreciate God's amazing creation and to realize that we as humans are just a small part of that creation and that we are interdependent with the rest of God's created world. Well, today we're beginning this new sermon series entitled A New Creation. As I shared in my Easter message last week, it is through the resurrection of Jesus that all things are being made new again. And that is for all of God's creation, not just for humanity. In fact, in Mark's telling of the resurrection, Jesus gives these final instructions to go into all the world and proclaim good news to the whole creation. We often hear these words as a call to share the gospel with other people, and that is certainly true. But it's because of Jesus' resurrection that we are given hope and new life. But this hope is for all creation. So today we begin this series by exploring how we, as human beings, sometimes tend to think that the world revolves around us. I know I've been guilty of that more often than I care to admit. We are just a part of God's magnificent creation. So what does creation tell us if we listen? Well, I know there's many among you who are gardeners and animal lovers. Living here in Minnesota in the land of 10,000 lakes, many of you like to fish, and you are allies in wanting to defend the natural habitats. And so you've spent a lot of time learning about the natural world so to protect it. I know there's some of you have chosen to be vegetarians or vegans for some of the same reasons. Here at Messiah Church, we've already done a lot to care for creation. Some of our indoor efforts include a high-efficiency HVAC, professionally maintained and computer-monitored and controlled. 2 years ago, we switched to all LED lighting throughout the building. We are in the process of moving towards eco-friendly, compostable hospitality ware. We've improved our efforts to recycle, we're collecting organics, and we have an eco-friendly cleaning materials that are used throughout the building. Our outdoor projects that are complete or underway include 2 rain gardens on our church property. We have a 3rd in the planning stages for this summer. We have native planting near the lake with oversight by Minnehaha Watershed District that uses only eco-friendly approved chemicals. The watering of our grounds that complies with Plymouth's city restrictions and it uses timers and zone watering. And our snow removal service uses only eco-friendly chemicals. While there are many things we are doing, there is still much more that can be done. Psalm 104 offers us a perspective of humanity as a part of God's creation, not merely the rulers over the rest of creation. God as creator and sustainer is emphasized throughout this psalm. God created humankind, but as the psalm poetically declares, God also created the earth, the waters of the earth, and the birds and the goats and the rabbits and the young lions and all the animals of the forest, cattle, the trees of the field and the cedars of Lebanon and fir trees. Not only is God the creator, but God cares for and provides for the needs of all of God's creation. God provides drink for every wild animal, trees in which the birds have their nest, grass for cattle and plants for people to cultivate. The trees of the field are watered abundantly, and even the predators, such as the lions, cry out to the Lord for sustenance. In God's wisdom, God has created all. We see this in other places in the Old Testament as well. In Job chapter 12, Job is talking to his friends, and he says, "Ask Behemoth." Behemoth was one of the mightiest animals. "Ask Behemoth, and he will teach you. The birds in the sky, and they will tell you. Or talk to the earth, and it will teach you. The fish of the sea will recount it for you. Among all these, who hasn't known that the Lord's hand did this, in whose grasp is the life of everything and the breath of every person?" This is a reminder to us of our place in creation, that the natural world is imagined as a teacher of human beings. So we need to learn to turn to the natural world that reminds us that the hand of the Lord has created all of us and that the life of every living thing and the breath of every human being are in God's hands. Reminders of God's care for all creatures can be found throughout the New Testament as well. Here in Matthew 6, we read, "Why do you worry about clothes? Notice how the lilies of the field grow. They don't wear themselves out with work. They don't spin cloth. But I say to you that even Solomon in all of his splendor wasn't dressed like one of these. If God dresses grass in the field so beautifully, even though it's alive today and tomorrow it's thrown in the furnace, won't God do much more than this for you?" You know, Jesus is present with us in all of creation. It reminds me of the hymn "In the Garden" that says, "I come to the garden alone while the dew is still on the roses. And he walks with me and he talks with me and he tells me that I am his own." This beloved hymn, sung at many celebration of life services, expresses what so many of us experience when we are truly present in nature. We experience the resurrected Christ. And in this season of resurrection here in Minnesota, it is spring, and there are signs of new life all around us. The trees are beginning to flower, big fat mama birds are hopping around in our front yards, and little baby birds are in nests. In fact, just yesterday, I noticed our little silver mound out in our front yard is starting to spring forth with new life. I bet if you look out in your yard, you're going to see similar signs of life all around you. Well, J. Clinton McCann Jr., a professor of theology at Eden Theological Seminary in St. Louis, makes several valuable observations in his reflections of Psalm 104. He notes that the origin and destiny of humankind is inextricably tied to the origin and destiny of the earth. And he reminds us that the word human is from the Latin word humus, which means soil. And the Hebrew words for human, Adam, and fertile land, Adamah, sound alike. This emphasizes the connection between human beings and the land. And it is a good reminder that we need to remember that the land still nourishes our lives. McCann also notes that everything we do has an effect on God's world and therefore on God. And he also makes several valuable observations about the importance of praising God as the beginning of environmental consciousness. It begins with the words, "Bless the Lord, O my soul." That's Psalm 104. And it ends with the words, "Praise the Lord." This is a praise-centered approach with an environmental consciousness born of fear, in which our primary concern is ourselves. And although many humans in our time think that nature is here to serve us, I think it's quite the opposite. We are, in fact, meant to serve God's creation. You know, we live in a time in which thinking we are able to save the world independent of our Creator has resulted in devastating imbalances in the world that are most deeply and tragically experienced by creatures who cannot advocate for themselves. According to the Center for Biological Diversity in 2023, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service removed 21 species from their list due to their extinction. These include several species of birds, mussels, a Texas fish, and a tiny fruit bat. And they join a list of over 650 species that have been lost to extinction just here in the United States. This also affects human beings, the poorest of the poor, who do not have the resources to deal with the effects of climate change, or limited and impure water sources, food deserts, and polluted air. Many of these changes are the result of human greed and a lack of understanding of consciousness of our actions. According to the World Health Organization, we are experiencing humanitarian emergencies that range from heat waves to wildfires to floods to tropical storms and hurricanes at an increasing scale and frequency and intensity. They estimate that 3.6 billion people already live in areas that are highly susceptible to climate change. Between 2030 and 2050, climate change is expected to cause approximately 250,000 additional deaths each year. Each year. From undernutrition, malaria, diarrhea, and heat stroke alone. Today, I want to invite you to reflect on how you react to the news that you hear every day about the effects of climate change. and the loss of habitat and species extinction. I know if you're like me, this information can leave you feeling overwhelmed to the point where you lose hope. And along with that, the will to make changes in your own life that will lessen the bad effects on our environment. In her book, Saving Us, A Climate Scientist Case for Hope and Healing in a Divided World, author Catherine Hayhoe says, to care about climate change, you only need to be one thing, and that's a person living on the planet Earth who wants a better future. And chances are, you're already that person, and so is everyone else you know. So if we can acknowledge that creation is a gift from God and care of that creation is up to us, what can we do to make a difference? Well, one first and easy step is to find time just to appreciate God's creation. This might include a walk in a natural setting, spending time in a garden or beside a lake, or perhaps it's a conversation with a park naturalist. Maybe you want to hang bird feeders this year or plant plants that attract our native insects and moths and butterflies. Throughout this sermon series and our Grow, Pray, Study guide, that daily devotional that we mail out each day, we call it our GPS, we're including a section called Did You Know? And in this section, we're going to share some interesting facts and some simple actions you can take to make a difference. It's my hope that you'll look these over and pick one or two things that you're not doing now and give it a try. Former senior pastor Raleigh Robinson leads a Bible study here on Wednesday mornings, and over the course of this past year, several members of his class have come to me and said, we want to do something about this. And so together they have provided a reusable bag that is available to you in our church office. You can pick it up and keep it in your car or take it with you when you shop. That way you're going to avoid using paper bags or plastic bags. And inside this reusable bag, you're going to find a sheet that lists more information and resources. They're also providing a variety of books that you can check out during the week. Evie's been hard at work acquiring and cataloging many books for our Messiah Church Library. And these books include things for children that can help us understand the situation and learn more about what we can do to make a difference. This group of folks has also provided the information that you'll find on our new Creation Care webpage, beautifully designed by our very own Tracy Ickes. And the information is provided by Raleigh's class members. You can find that webpage at messiahchurch.org/creationcare. Now remember, a life of faith is more than just about going to church. Loving creation is a way of loving the author of creation and appreciating the good gifts God has given. Loving creation can also motivate us to make changes in our own lives to better care for our environment. As a faith community called Messiah Church, we have the opportunity to come together and to praise God, remembering that God asks us to be caregivers of this incredible world. Well, I want to end our time together today with this blessing written by Benedictine sister Ruth Marlene Fox. May God bless you with discomfort at easy answers, half-truths, and superficial relationships so that you may live deep within your heart. May God bless you with anger at injustice, oppression, and exploitation of people so that you may work for justice, freedom, and peace. May God bless you with tears to shed for those who suffer pain, rejection, hunger, and war, so that you may reach out your hand to comfort them and to turn their pain to joy. And may God bless you with enough foolishness to believe that you can make a difference in this world, so that you can do what others claim cannot be done, to bring justice and kindness to all children and the poor. Amen.
Some days we forget to look around us. Some days can't see the joy that surrounds us. So caught up inside ourselves, we take when we should give. So for today, what we know can be, and on this day we hope for what we still can't see. It's up to us to be the change, and even though we all can still do more, there's so much to be thankful for. Look beyond ourselves, there's so much sorrow. It's way too late to say, I'll cry to of us must find our truth, it's so long overdue. So for today we pray for what we know can be, and on this day we hope for what we still can't see. Up to us to be the change, and even though we all can still do more, there's so much to be thankful for. Even with our differences, there is a place we're all connected. Each of us can find each other's light. For tonight we pray for what we know can be, and on this day we hope for what we still can't see. It's up to us to be the change. This world needs so much more. There's so much to be thankful for.
Thank you for joining us for Church on the Go. I hope that you found something in this week's message or scripture or a line from the song that you'll carry with you into the week ahead. I encourage you to share this message with your friends and family. Next week, we're taking a break from Church on the Go as we celebrate Youth Sunday at Messiah Church, where our youth are in charge of all parts of the worship service, including a message that is Saturday Night Live themed. And it's not going to translate so well to audio. So I encourage you to check it out at messiahchurch.org. To learn more about Messiah Church, you can also find us on YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram at Messiah Church MN. We'll be back on April 21st with a message called A Special Responsibility. You know, we are but one part of a vast creation, and humanity has been given a special responsibility by God. As those created in the image of God, we are called to care for the earth that, in turn, sustains us. I hope that you'll join us on April 21st for the next installment of the New Creation Sermon Series.